Hello and welcome to my channel. So today I thought I would film a bit of a closet wardrobe sorting out and a bit of a tour. So I needed to do this anyway. I'm going to be moving soon, and when I move I'm not going to have as much space to store all of my clothes, so a sort of clean out and a bit of a purge was needed anyway, and I thought, why don't I film it so you guys can see it? And the other reason I wanted to do it is because I wanted to reorganise my wardrobes so that I can find things a bit easier, and also I'd really like one wardrobe to be organised sort of into outfits. So actually on each hanger there's an outfit already put together. So in the video today, I'm going to just basically have a bit of a sort out, show you some of my favourite pieces, talk you through the bits that I'm getting rid of, and also show you guys some of the outfits that I'm going to put together. And then at the end, give you a bit of a tour of my finished and hopefully much more tidy wardrobes. So lots of you might have watched the documentary on Netflix, the Marie Kondo, Tidying with Marie Kondo, and one of her things is before you have a sort out that you should take everything out of your wardrobes and pile it on the bed. And that's what I've done. And oh my god, it's actually quite frightening how many clothes I have. So I need to show you this first. So here is the pile of clothes. And actually, another confession, this isn't actually all of my clothes. No, I actually have more clothes than this because some of my clothes are in the loft. So some of you might do the same thing, but I do a bit of a biannual swap around. So when the weather gets a bit cooler or the weather gets a bit warmer, I either bring down my summer wardrobe and I send a lot of my winter wardrobe up, or vice versa. Again, I'm not going to have room for that because when I move I'm actually going to go back into rented, and a lot of rented accommodation in the UK, you don't get access to the loft. Therefore, I have to be able to fit all of my belongings into a house. And that's my clothes, really, is what takes up most of the room. So I'm not going to have the luxury of that. But for now, I'm going to ignore what's in the loft and I'm just going to deal with what's here. I also have made a bit of a start. I've actually tidied up and my jumpers already, and all of my shoes. So my jumpers actually live in my bed. So my bed is one of those beds that lifts up. So at the end, when I finished tidying and all the bed is clear, I'll lift it up and I'll show you inside how I've organised my jumpers. So one of the first things I thought I would do is just show you the wardrobe space that I got. They're both IKEA wardrobes. I think it's the PAX system. And I have two with sort of baskets and whatnot inside, two with mirror doors and two without. So yeah, let's have a little look at the space that I have to utilise. It's quite a lot of space, to be fair. So this is wardrobe number one. So as you can see, I've already got shoes in here. So in here are all of my flats and boots. And there's a little box at the back there. This wardrobe has two baskets that slide out so I can utilise these, and then just a rail. And I use these flock hangers. Not only do things stay on them better, but also they're so flat, they take up hardly any space. So you can fit loads in your wardrobe if you use these. I buy mine from Primark, but you can also get them at places like Home Bargains, Wilkinson's. But yeah, quite a lot of room in there to fill. So that's wardrobe number one. So in wardrobe number two, I've also already sorted out my shoes. So in here is all of my trainers. Got a few different pairs, including my recent leopard print purchases from Primark. And then there's also another basket in this wardrobe, and then up to another rail. So again, I'm using the flock hangers. And then I've also got these flock hangers, which are for hanging trousers, because I do own a lot of trousers. I also own a lot of clothes covered in dog hair. That is the downside of owning two dogs. So as you can see, I've pretty much emptied everything. So there's a few bits hanging on hangers here, because when I sorted everything out, I knew for a fact that I was going to keep these. So I didn't really see the point of chucking them on the bed. This also doesn't include anything that's in the washing basket, which is also quite a lot. So yeah, a little bit embarrassed about how many clothes I own. I won't talk you through every single piece I own. I think the best thing to do is for me just to get sorting, and every time something of note comes up, I'll show you guys. So yeah, I hope you find it interesting and enjoying? I hope you find it interesting and you enjoy it. But yeah, I need to get going because this has all been piled on my bed for 2 days now, waiting to be filmed. So let's get going. Okay, so I need to have a think about what I want to put in each wardrobe and what to utilise the baskets for. So I'm thinking that this wardrobe is going to be just for clothes generally. Or maybe this should be for outfits and the other ones for clothes generally. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. So this wardrobe is going to be for outfits that are already put together. And I think this basket is going to be for jeans, because I do own a lot of jeans. And then in this wardrobe, I'm going to hang, obviously, shorter items, general clothes. I'm going to do that really cool way of folding tops that Marie Kondo does, where you can sort of see everything. Stack them up in this basket. And then, not sure about this lower basket, but let's be honest, there's enough stuff to fill two wardrobes. So that's my plan. I also will have to, along with outfits, probably hang jumpsuits and things in this wardrobe, because this one has the most like length, as it were, for stuff to hang. So I might actually just start with what's on the door, because I know I'm going to keep these things. Because if you followed me for a while, you'll know, or you follow me on Instagram, you will know that my favourite thing in the world to wear is a jumpsuit. So I do own a lot of jumpsuits. I think they're so easy to wear, they're so comfy, and yeah, they're just, I would say they're my signature piece. So these are some of my jumpsuits that I'm definitely keeping. So this one you'll have seen in my What's New in My Wardrobe, or What I Bought in January video. This is from ASOS. If any of this stuff is current, I will link it in the description box if you're interested, but obviously a lot of my clothes will be old. They won't be necessarily available anymore, but if it is, I will link it for you. But yeah, I love this jumpsuit. The only thing that bugs me about it is it has no pockets, and I like pockets in a jumpsuit, but it's too nice to get rid of. So that is definitely staying. So that's just gonna go straight in. And then this, oh, this is one of my favorite ever jumpsuits. This is actually Whistles. And I didn't buy this. I got it for a photo shoot. So I did a photo shoot with an amazing photographer called Alex Cameron, who honestly, her photos are just stunning. It was a dream of mine to be shot by her. And it was a collaboration with John Lewis. So this came from John Lewis, but it's Whistles. And it's this beautiful, like ochre yellow colour, and yellow is massive for spring summer 19. I saw that on something on telly, it said. So I would never get rid of this. It's got a beautiful open back. It would make an amazing wedding outfit if I had to go to a wedding or anything special. And yeah, I love it. So, and I would never necessarily afford to buy this myself. I think it was about £150. And although I love it and I've worn it loads, I don't tend to spend that much money on a single item of clothing. So it's a bit of a treat for me that I got it gifted because of the photo shoot. Oh, this jumpsuit. So this was a gift from Emma. Emma got this. It's actually Kate Spade. And she knows how much I love Kate Spade, and she knows how much I love jumpsuits. So she gave me this, and I took it to Miami and I just wore it to death. And denim jumpsuits and like boiler suit type things are all over the high street now. So I'm definitely not getting rid of that because I do love it. So I'm not doing very well so far. I haven't got rid of anything, but I will, I promise. Right, now, you will all have something in your wardrobe like this, which is an item of clothing that you've never really worn. I've worn this once. But A, it costs you so much money you don't want to get rid of it. And B, when you look at it, you just think it's so beautiful. Now, if you have watched the Marie Kondo documentary program on Netflix, she says to people when they're tidying, you have to look at it and decide if it sparks joy. And the thing is, when I look at this, it does spark joy. So it's a River Island beaded kimono. And I bought it a few years ago. It's this kind of mushroomy colour. And I bought it when kimonos were like the thing that everybody was wearing. Do you remember that season when literally that's all anybody was wearing? And it's got beading all on the back and everything. And every time I've come to it and gone, oh, I'm going to get rid of that, I then try it on and I think, oh, it's so pretty. And I think, oh, if I was going out for drinks or, you know, it would be such a nice thing to wear. Have I worn it? No. And in my heart, I know I should probably sell it. Because then somebody else would get wear out of it. It's going back in the wardrobe. Because it's just, it cost me so much money. Honestly, it cost me so much money. Oh, this is a bit boring. I won't bore you with this, but I keep loads of vest tops on a single hanger. So I'm just going to sort through these and get rid of any that are tatty. Okay, so there is an area that I definitely need to have a purge of, and that is suits. I own a lot of suits, and it's because I just really like them. I love them with trainers, I love the look of them, and I've just recently got a new one from Amazon, which was in my last video, but I feel like, I think I've got four suits. I'm just not sure that I should have that many in my wardrobe. So the first one is this neck suit, which is like a check with a kind of orange tinge in it. This I'm definitely going to keep because it fits really, really nice. The jacket is lovely. A checked blazer will never not be something that you can, you know, you can't wear. So that is going to stay. So that'll go in this wardrobe, which then means that these are just a pair of checked trousers. I don't need another pair of checked trousers if I've got those ones. So they are gone. See that? Decisive. Gone. This is a little striped number with shorts, but this does look really, really nice together, and a little short suit is cute for summer, so I'm going to keep this one. This is a Dorothy Perkins one. Okay, this pinstripe suit. Yeah, I'm not doing very well here at all. I don't think I'm going to get rid of any suits. I've said I was going to get rid of one. I'm going to pop it back in my wardrobe for now and maybe make an effort to wear it. Well, let's do t-shirts because they're right here. I own so many t-shirts, like a scary amount of t-shirts. So I definitely need a purge here. And this will be where I have to do this jazzy folding technique to fit them all into that basket. So this is a really cute little t-shirt. It's a little leopard print. So yeah, I need to do this jazzy folding technique that she does. I'm going to have a go first and then I'll show you if I can master it. So there we go, I'm going to fold them into little rectangles like this. So to fold it the Marie Kondo way, you fold the arm in like this and the other side in. It's going to be a bit messy because I'm doing it with one hand like this. And then if it's a longer sleeve top, you actually fold the arms over again like that. And then you fold it into thirds, as it were. Fold half up like that. Like this. Look, it's covered in dog hair now because I put it on the carpet. Like that. And then you end up with a little rectangle. And then my plan is to stack them in the drawer like this. Okay, so I'm going to really, really quickly sort through the ones that I'm going to keep, and then I'll fold everything. So, some basic plain colour ones. I have loads of like slogan tees, and I do like them, like this sort of band tee, keeping plain grey V-neck t-shirt. You can't go wrong with a plain grey. This is just a striped one. That one's going to go. I'm going to try and be brutal here. Be brutal. This one, go. Not this one. This one's my Adopt Don't Shop from Wild at Heart Foundation t-shirt. Keep him. This one, you see, I already had some t-shirts folded. This one is so cute. I wore this in a video before. This is a little Oasis t-shirt with a little rainbow on it. So keeping that, that can stay folded. My Bella Freud t-shirt. Oh, definitely keeping this. This is my Topshop Eagle tee. I bought this years ago in the Topshop sale. Every time I wear it, I get so many questions about where it's from. This is another really cute t-shirt. This is an Amazon find t-shirt, really nice. So yeah, I'm doing really well. I've so far got rid of one. No, I'm gonna get rid of this actually. I really like it, little striped thing, but it's absolutely freaking tiny. And I don't think I fit in it anymore. Same with this, see? I'm starting to be brutal. Oh, this is my t-shirt from when me and Jay went to Miami. Yeah, no, I can't get rid of that, but I might put this into my, so I have a drawer of like loungewear stuff, which is more for like, you know, just lazing around the house. I might just put it in that drawer. T-shirt's done. Now I've got a few long sleeved tops, which again, I'm gonna do the same folding technique. This one's really cute. This is from Next, the little pair of glasses there. I've got a couple of striped tops from Bowdoin, including this one with a little slogan on, and this multicoloured one. Oh, this is nice though. This is a Bowken top that just says love in gold. But again, I would wear this more as like a slouchy around the house. So I think I might add that to my loungewear drawer. Oh yeah, this is a black polo neck, like a little lightweight ribbed one. One of these is just brilliant for your wardrobe. Don't ever get rid of this kind of top because you can just put it underneath stuff when it's a little bit colder. So they're all gonna get folded. So I'm gonna put them on my folding pile. Okay, now I'm gonna move on to sort of like little tops and just, yeah, be really, really brutal. Oh, this is my little top from Zara that I took to Paris with me when me and Emma went. So I'm going to keep that because it's a really, really nice sort of textured little t-shirt. It's a little bit different. One of the good things about going through your wardrobe like this is that you can rediscover things, but also hopefully it inspires you to put outfits together. So as I come across things, I might actually just put them together. So I'm thinking that this little striped, slightly high neck top would look really, really nice under this denim jumpsuit. So I'm actually going to put them on the hanger together. So that then when I look in my wardrobe and I'm like, oh, what can I wear? There's pieces already put together to sort of either grab and just put on or even to inspire you, like, you know, to create a different outfit. But sometimes it's hard when you own so much stuff to work out what will go nice together. But yeah, I feel like that under that looks really, really nice. So I'm gonna hang that. So this side of this wardrobe is going to be for outfits. Yeah, it's a cute little outfit that. Might wear that next week. Now, I seem to have a surprising number of bodies. For somebody who never liked bodies, I've got quite a few, like this sort of ribbed one here, and then I've got a couple from Primark, this black one with a zip on it, and this mustard one. And they're nice for layering, but I mean, how many does one woman need? So having come across this striped top that sits off the shoulder, I have these dungarees from ASOS. They're a blue denim, and I reckon that this top would look really, really nice underneath. So I'm gonna hang these on the same hanger. Yeah, so I think that looks really, really nice underneath. And the thing is, I could even go as far, if I wanted to hang earrings on there or a scarf and things that would go with it. But for now, I'm just gonna stick with hanging those together. So I have a couple of camis, which are like, got lace on the top. I've got a pink one and a black one. And I think these are just really, really easy to wear tops. So I'm gonna keep both of those on one hanger. Now, this top, oh dear. So I bought this in the Zara sale, and I'll be honest, I bought it because it reminded me of a top that Sarah Jessica Parker wears in Sex and the City, and I thought I could be all cool and Sex and the City-like, and I have never worn it. Never ever worn it. It's basically just like hairy, and it cost me something like $2.99. It really didn't cost me a lot of money, but yeah, I'm not sure. I think this, I might have to accept that maybe I'm not fashion-y enough to wear this and pull it off. It's also a bit scratchy, so it's going. So now I've sort of moved on slightly to more dressier tops. Got a few which I know I'm definitely not going to get rid of. So this is such a nice top. It sort of like comes up quite high, And like a little sort of crop top. It's from like the teenager section in H&M, but I just love it. I bought two at the same time. Bought this one, which is gold, it's long sleeved. And this one, which you all loved on my Instagram, which is the silver backless body. They're both not being got rid of. They're just really, really good night out tops. And even though I don't go out that often, when I do, I like wearing one of these. Okay, so let's move on to shirts. One of the reasons why I never seem to wear shirts is because a lot of them need ironing. And as I said, I don't iron. I just find ironing really boring. So if you watch my Emma Hill Does My Primark haul, you'll have seen this lovely linen shirt, which she got me. And I also liked it so much that I went back and got the khaki. And I love them, but they both need ironing. But I'm going to hang them on the same hanger because I am definitely going to keep them. This is a really, really cute shirt. This is a Bowden silk shirt, and it's just so, so pretty. But I don't know, I wish I could try things on, but you know, just like this over my striped shirt. Maybe I should just... Yeah, I mean, it's just so pretty, the print. I'm gonna put this in my outfit wardrobe to try and encourage me to pair it with something, get myself to wear it. Okay, we've got a couple of dresses here. This is a little leopard print dress, which actually looks really nice with a t-shirt under for the daytime. So I'm definitely not getting rid of this. It's kind of like a double layer. Oh, my sequin skirt. Do you remember this from my, before Christmas, I did a video of what's new. And I got it because, I mean, it would look really nice with this top. Because I just wanted to do that whole sequin skirt with a coat, with a t-shirt or a hoodie kind of casual look. Did I ever do it? No, but I'm not gonna get rid of it. What I'm gonna do is add it into my, I have a box of dresses. So because I don't wear dresses very often, I don't hang them in my wardrobe really, unless they're casual. So I'm gonna add it to that, because when I'm going to something special, I always pull out that box and have a look through it. This little dress from Amazon, this can go in my wardrobe because I reckon I would style that up with jeans and a biker jacket. Ah, this is such a cute little co-ord. This is little patterned joggers, and there's a top that goes with it as well. Here it is, a little vest top. I wore this when I went to Wireless Festival. This is by Noisy May, which is a brand at Debenhams. Although I do have a pink jumper, maybe these trousers with a pink jumper would look really cool. Maybe I should put it in my wardrobe outfit, my outfit wardrobe. I'm getting more into skirts. Oh, this is one of my favourite jumpsuits ever. This is not going anywhere. This is a Wallis jumpsuit. It's polka dot, 3/4 length, culotte bottoms, and it's just the comfiest thing in the entire world to wear. I've worn it to christenings, to parties. You can dress it up, you dress it down. So yeah, not getting rid of that. Oh, this is my next animal print skirt, which I wore in a photo, and I was like, oh, I'm not sure about that, I'm gonna get rid. And then I put it on my Instagram, and so many of you commented like, no, you look great in it. But I didn't get rid of it because actually I thought, oh, maybe I do pull it off. But yeah, maybe this should go in my outfit wardrobe and I should create an outfit with it. This is another skirt which is really nice, I'm not getting rid of. This is a little Balkan polka dot frill number, which actually does look really, really nice on with trainers and a little t-shirt. Okay, I can't decide about this stripy number. It's from Next. I got it last year to go to Miami, and I do like it, but my god, you have to be tan to wear it, otherwise you just look so pasty in it. Is it Sparking Joy? No. No, it is not. It is Sparking Thoughts of Fake Tan is what it is sparking. This is just a really easy to wear little Zara polka dot dress. I don't think you ever get rid of a dress like that. This is quite nice, this rust jacket. This actually goes with, there is a pair of, look, rust coloured trousers. The two things together make, I mean, they're a statement together, but I quite like it, a little bit cowboy. And that eagle print t-shirt that I showed you earlier looks really, really nice under them. So I'm going to put it together as a whole outfit in my outfit wardrobe with the t-shirt. I wore this the other night to go out for drinks. Finally wore it. This is my Zara velvet embroidered jacket, and I still stand by the fact that is the nicest jacket in the entire world, and I won't ever get rid of it, partly because it cost me an absolute flipping fortune, and just because I think velvet will be in fashion every like winter season. So yeah, love it. And then I've got a couple of sort of khaki type jackets, camo. This one will look really nice on top of this striped top. How nice is that? This is misguided, it's really old though, but I won't get rid of it. In fact, I think Emma had it first and I liked it so much I went and bought it. That's what happens whenever I hang out with Emma. So I always end up going and buying the thing that she's wearing. So some jumpers that aren't in the bed, or inside the bed, and that's because I want to be able to see them, so I want to hang them up, or maybe they go in, I think maybe they go in this lower basket here, so maybe I need to fold them up. So once again, I'm going to sort through them quickly and then I'll fold them at my leisure, because you don't need to like sit and watch me fold stuff for 3 hours. This little cardigan from New Look with buttons, keeping, that's relatively new. Well, not relatively new, but it's really, really nice on. My pink hoodie, which is new, that's being kept. My Bowden cashmere bright coloured striped jumper, I won't ever get rid of that because it's just so cheery and so happy. This is my Zara, like, I look like I'm going to the gym, but I don't go to the gym. Hoodie. I'm gonna hang that up. I don't go to the gym. I just own a lot of things that look like I do. So yeah, I'll fold those up off camera probably, because you don't really need to see me fold all of them. And obviously, as I said, I'm gonna do I'll do a little bit of filming of all the wardrobes when they're done and finished. So now the last thing, we're nearly there, is trousers and jeans. I own a lot of jeans and a lot of jeans that don't fit me very well, so I'm going to start with jeans and be quite quick and quite brutal. Okay, here we go, really brutal. These are black Primark jeans. They don't fit very well, so they're going, because I've recently bought myself a pair that do fit. So actually, only got rid of, did I get rid of any jeans? Possibly that pair. Oh, and I got rid of that pair over there, yeah. I don't know. So these are all going to go in this basket, I think. These are some camel trousers, wide leg. They're actually whistles. They were given to me by Emma. I shot Emma in them, and then I pestered her for about a year. Kept asking her, are you ever getting rid of those trousers? Are you ever getting rid of those trousers? And she did. She gave them to me. Am I lucky? Yeah, maybe they'll go in my outfit wardrobe. One of the reasons why I think I should put a lot of trousers in my outfit wardrobe is I always just wear jeans, and I think I need to remember to wear trousers other than jeans. And that's it. That's everything. Yeah. So I've got quite a lot of stuff to fold and put away. So I'm going to put my playlist on, and I'm going to get folding, put everything away in the wardrobe. So once all of that's done and I've put everything in the wardrobe, I'll give you a final tour of how everything looks. And yeah, hopefully it'll all be lovely and tidy and lovely and neat, and I'll be able to find everything really, really easily. So yeah, I'm going to crack on. Okay, so here's what inside the bed looks like. So this is where a lot of my jumpers are, and they're all neatly folded now. There's actually loads more room that I could probably fill, but at the moment this is enough for me to be in here. So I've got, yeah, quite a lot of my winter jumpers in here. And then in this box here is things that I am happy to sit on the sofa with the dogs wearing, because dog hair does sort of go everywhere. So trying to keep this box of things that are kind of loungy around covered in dog hair clothes. Unfortunately, such is owning a dog. So that's what's hidden inside my bed that lifts up.
And here is finished wardrobe number one. So this is just clothes. So I've got everything hung up. So along the top here, I've got trousers, sort of going out tops here, daytime tops, vest tops, shirts, blazers on the end here, and jumpers and things. Then I've done the folding for my t-shirts. I've got t-shirts all folded here, plain, these are all patterned, plain colours here, and then these are all my long sleeve tops, and I can see the design on them. So, so there's actually loads of room still. So that probably means that I can actually buy more clothes, does it? Then the pull-out drawer down is some more jumpers. So again, I've done the jazzy folding. We've got plain, pastely colours, stripes, and then sort of chunkier pastel and ribbed knits there. Then down at the bottom, shoes, flats, and boots. And this is wardrobe number two. So this is my outfits and sort of dresses wardrobe. Dresses and long jumpsuits, just so that there's room for them to hang. And then again, so the idea obviously of this wardrobe was either to remind me of things so that I remember to wear them, or to put outfits together. So these are just some trousers and skirts that I kind of forgot I had. So they're in there to sort of remind me to wear them. And then these are some of the outfits that I have put together. So here we've got this nice pearly knit, which I've put with this cropped pair of jeans. I've got a black pair of cropped jeans with a stripy top, and I've added a belt on there and a little scarf. And actually I wore that the other night. I needed a quick outfit to put on and it was really good. I just grabbed the whole hanger out and put the whole outfit on, put my yellow biker jacket on, and it looked great. I'm gonna try teaming these beige trousers with this animal print jumper, and even maybe this little headband as well. Little shirt and jumper combo, culottes, and a t-shirt. So yeah, so I've put together some sort of pieces that I think go well together. So if you guys want to see another video of, I don't know, 10 outfits styled up from my own wardrobe, if you guys think that would be cool and you would enjoy watching it, then I will very happily film it for you and show you some of these outfits. So then in the pull-out drawer, we've got all my jeans. Rolled them all up so that I can see the ends, because I tend to be able to identify what jeans they are by how the hem is, basically. So yeah, embellished, blue, black. And then down at the bottom is all of my trainers, which actually there's a couple of pairs downstairs which are muddy from walking the dogs. And that's it. That is my wardrobe's sorted out. Feel like they look a lot more streamlined. Everything's much, much easier to find. And I'm really, really enjoying the outfit wardrobe, just being able to grab things and put them on. I hope you enjoyed the video. Give it a thumbs up and obviously subscribe if you're not already a subscriber. And I shall see you again next time.